Good morning, students. Actually, we were learning the cloning vector in the last video. We studied the cloning vector like plasmid or PVR322, that is the modified plasmid. But whatever the cloning vectors we have studied so far, these cloning vectors are used for the bacteria, that how to transfer a desired gene into the bacteria, or you can say that the prokaryotic cells. But now today we will discuss that how to transfer a desired gene into a plant cell or a animal cell. These are the eukaryotic cells. So which vectors, cloning vectors, we can use to deliver a desired gene into a plant cell or animal cell? So we will study today that how to deliver a desired gene or alien piece of DNA or any foreign DNA into a eukaryotic cell, or you can say that into the animal cell or plant cells. How to deliver, we will discuss. In the bacteria, we have studied that through the plasmid, through the bacteriophages. Also we studied in the last video, we studied that the bacteria also can be, bacteriophages can also be used as the cloning vector to transfer the desired gene into the bacteria. Plasmids are also used to transfer the desired gene or foreign DNA into a host or into the bacteria. But now how to deliver a desired gene or any alien piece of DNA or foreign DNA into the plant cell or animal cell? These are the eukaryotic cells. So actually our scientist studied the many bacteria and viruses. They studied the bacteria and viruses, and they found that, they observed that these bacteria and the viruses have the ability to transfer a piece of DNA into its host cell and transform and causes the transformation of the host cell according to their requirements. What we studied that, our scientists studied that, they found that there are many bacteria and viruses, they infect the many plants and animal cell or eukaryotic cell, and they are able, or they have the ability to transfer a piece of DNA or transfer a DNA into its host cell and causes the transformation of the host cell for its own requirement. For example, our scientist studied about the Agrobacterium tumefaciens. Agrobacterium tumefaciens, a type of bacteria. It is a pathogen that infect the many dicot plants and causes in the dicot plants, when this Agrobacterium tumefaciens, when infect a dicot plant or when it enter into an eukaryotic plant cell, what it do? It transfer a piece of DNA into that host cell, and that piece of DNA is also called the tDNA. Why it is called tDNA, we will discuss. So scientists found that, they studied that, they observed that when this Agrobacterium tumefaciens, when infect a plant cell, any dicot plant cell, what it do? It transfer a piece of DNA into the host cell and causes the transformation of normal cells of that host, normal cells of the plant, into the tumors. What it do? When it deliver or it transfer a piece of DNA, that piece of DNA is called the tDNA, into the host cell. And what it do, this tDNA? It causes the transformation of the normal cells into tumor. And after that, when the normal cell now transform into the tumor, and then the tumor, then it direct the tumor cells to produce the chemical that is required for the agrobacterium. So what we learned here, that our scientist studied that when this agrobacterium tumefaciens, when infect any eukaryotic cell or plant cell, any dicot plant, it transfer or deliver a piece of DNA, that is the tDNA. What it do? It transform these normal cells of that plant into tumor, and the tumor and direct the tumor cells to produce the chemical which are required for this bacteria. Likewise, our scientists also studied many retroviruses. I think you know retroviruses. Retroviruses means such kind of viruses which shows the reverse transcription, like AIDS virus, this is the RNA virus. So in retroviruses, there is the reverse transcription occurs in the presence of reverse transcriptase, in which the RNA, from the RNA, it forms the DNA, from RNA to DNA. Normally in replication what occurs? DNA to DNA, and then DNA to RNA, that is called the transcription. But in the retroviruses, there is the reverse transcription occurs in presence of reverse transcriptase enzyme, in which the RNA genome changes into the DNA. For example, when the AIDS virus, this is the RNA virus, when enter into the host cell, like the macrophages of human being, macrophages is a type of cell that helps, phagocytic cell that found in the areolar connective tissue. So this AIDS virus, when attack a macrophage, so the RNA of the AIDS virus enter into the macrophage cell, and after entering the RNA, now it in the presence of reverse transcriptase enzyme, it forms the DNA, viral DNA, from RNA to DNA, and then that DNA incorporates with the host DNA and direct the cell for the synthesis of new viruses. Similarly, there are the viruses, retroviruses studied by the scientists, that it also deliver a piece of DNA and transform the normal cells into cancerous cell or tumor cells, cancerous cell. Retroviruses transform normal cells into cancerous cells. So our scientists now thought that these agrobacterium and these retroviruses can be used as a cloning vector, because they have the ability to transfer a piece of DNA into the host cell and causes the transformation. So if we ligate them, now if we ligate a foreign DNA or desired DNA in these bacteria and viruses, and we know that these bacteria and virus have the ability to deliver a piece of DNA or gene into the host cell, our desired gene can also be introduced into the host cell. For example, suppose we want to introduce a desired gene into the plant cells, we can use the plasmid of this agrobacterium tumefaciens. Okay, plasmid of the plant. So suppose this is the plasmid of agrobacterium tumefaciens, and in this plasmid, suppose this is the tDNA. Suppose this one is the tDNA. Suppose this is the tDNA. This one is the tDNA. So if we ligate a desired gene in this tDNA, what will occur? The tDNA will be inactivated due to the insertional inactivation. So it means now after that this plasmid agrobacterium is now allowed to infect the plant cell. When this agrobacterium infect the plant cell, it will transfer this tDNA into the host cell, and along with the tDNA, our desired gene will also be entered in that host cell. And here what we studied, that ड्यू टू द इंसर्शन ऑफ अ डिजायर्ड जीन और फॉरेन डीएनए इन दिस टीडीएनए, द टीडीएनए बिकम्स इनएक्टिवेटेड ड्यू टू द इंसर्शनल इनएक्टिवेशन. बट इन दिस एग्रोबैक्टीरियम इन स्पाइट ऑफ दिस देयर इज द एबिलिटी टू ट्रांसफर द पीस ऑफ डीएनए इन टू द होस्ट सेल. सो इफ वी एड, इफ वी लाइगेट अ डिजायर्ड जीन इन दिस टीडीएनए, the tDNA will be inactivated, but the ability of the this bacteria to transfer this tDNA is present. So when we allow this bacterium to infect our plant cell, our desire, and this bacterium when transfer the plasmid or transfer a piece of DNA into the host cell, our desired gene will be also introduced in the host cell. So in this way we can do the transformation. Likewise, the retroviruses, there are also have the ability to transfer a piece of DNA into the host cell and transform the normal cell into cancerous cell or tumor cell. We can also disarm means make it inactivate. So we can also disarm this retroviruses. Our scientists have developed this retroviruses also as a cloning vector. So we can use this retroviruses after that to make it inactivated or disarmed, we can say that. So retroviruses have also been disarmed to use as the cloning vector. And through this retroviruses, we can introduce a piece of DNA or desired DNA into an animal cell. So these are the cloning vectors we can use. And whether it is plasmid or bacteriophage or agrobacterium, plasmid or retroviruses, once it is a desired gene ligated in these cloning vectors and introduced into the bacteria or plant or animal, in that bacteria, plant or animal, the our desired gene will replicate, increase their number. This is called the cloning. So this agrobacterium and this retroviruses can also be used as the cloning vector. Thank you.